We recovered the body of a small child whose physical description and clothing description matches that of our kidnapping victim.
And new information tonight in the search for 4-year-old Juliani Cardenas after a child's body is found in a canal. Investigators are saying this missing person case is now a homicide. The child found in the canal has not been positively identified. Investigators say it could take weeks before DNA tests are finished.
Yeah, and tonight, one Stanislaus County Sheriff's Department is offering his condolences, or I should say the sheriff is offering condolences to the Cardenas family. And right now, people are getting ready for a memorial prayer service for Juliani that starts in less than an hour from now.
The new information in the search for Juliani is in full focus tonight at 6. We start with KCRA3's Rich Ibarra.
Well, first, City Hall in Patterson has been a busy place throughout the day. First, we had a news conference from the Stanislaus Sheriff. And now, if you look behind me, people are gathering for a prayer service that will commence in about an hour. Now, the body was found this morning near Santa Nella in Merced County in the Delta Mendota Canal. It's been 2 weeks since the suspect, Jose Rodriguez, and Juliani disappeared in the cold waters of the canal.
We've lost the life of a little boy.
As Stanislaus Sheriff Adam Christensen broke the sad news of today's discovery, people gathered in front of City Hall. Throughout Patterson, flyers were still posted on windows, many hoping for the impossible that 4-year-old Juliani was still alive.
Just in me to think of all the hope I had for him being alive, and it turning out very differently. And I'm so sad about it.
This small city continued to reach out for Juliani's safe return for the last 2 weeks, with blue and yellow ribbons on the doors of City Hall and on trees outside the family home. A hard jolt of reality has suddenly taken hold.
At least now we know, and he's in a better place in heaven, but it's not where we wanted to find him.
The sheriff has indicated DNA could take weeks to provide a positive ID, but with the matching clothes and the boy's description, that leaves little room for doubt. The community has rallied around the family with support, and in the coming days, the community doesn't plan to stop. If anything, more will be needed.
And I think we need to heal. We need to come together, and I think that's what this community has started to do, and I think that's what it's famous for. And
now, right now, people are gathering on the corners of the street and in front of City Hall, and at 7, they will join hands in a prayer vigil. Tonight at 6:30, we'll also hear why an arrest warrant has been issued for Jose Rodriguez. In Patterson, Rich Ibarra, KCRA 3 reports.